What is my greatest fear? My greatest fear, and it terrifies me, is that death is really the end. That near-death experiences are just an illusion. A sweet deception produced by the dying brain and the dying mind. To ease us in to the transition from being alive into everlasting oblivion. Nothingness. And Aristotle said nothing is what rocks dream about. My terror is that when you die, you become the same thing that rocks dream about, which is nothing. It terrifies me. It's made me afraid since I was in the 7th grade. But then I came across near-death experiences in the 7th grade and 8th grade, and it comforted me that there was life after death, but the fear still was there. When Pizza Hut was robbed in August of 1995 and they stuck that gun to my head for a fraction of a second, long enough to push me over to the other people lying on the floor, the thought, what if he pulls that trigger? What if I don't die but become brain damaged? It's terrifying. What if death really is then? All those beautiful near-death experiences and assurances that there was life after death went out the window when that gun was pointed at my head. It's terrifying. That death is the end. I used to say this. I don't say this anymore. This is what I used to say. I had rather had to burn in hell forever and ever. At least I'd be conscious. Then when I die, that's it. Lights out. Total oblivion. And if you want to know what the darkness of death looks like, don't close your eyes. That's not what the darkness of death looks like. Pretend you're opening your eyes in the back of your head. What do you see? You see darkness? No, you see nothing. Literally nothing. You don't see any colors. You don't see blackness. And imagine it being that, but plus you're not conscious. Is that what death is? It terrifies me. To this day, how am I gonna keep from denying Jesus when they point the gun in my head? If I'm not sure that is life after death, there's a seed in me, something in me that has to keep on believing in Jesus. I should have abandoned Jesus. Years, decade, maybe a decade or so ago. But I keep on believing in Jesus. They've proven that the Exodus and all those stories in the Bible, the conquest of Israel by Joshua, didn't happen. Why do I keep believing in Jesus? I just can't stop believing in Jesus. It's not just because of fear of going to hell. If I don't believe in Jesus, I'm utterly miserable. Miserable. Even if I do get my dreams of being a hot guy, having long forearms and looking like a kid, without Jesus, I'm nothing. I need Jesus. But I am the near-death experiences I've seen, the contradictions, the inconsistencies. Near-death experiences now are doing more to make me doubt whether there's life after death than what science has proven. But working together, coupled with science and archaeology, is making it me think death is something to be terrified of. I'm terrified of dying. I'm terrified. It's not that I'm terrified. Dying is, I'm terrified that there is no life after death. You look at the Bible, Lazarus was raised from the dead. All those people raised from the dead, not one damn one of them mentioned a near-death experience or seen anything on the other side. Sometimes that makes me doubt whether they were really raised from the dead. Or they're, because if they were really raised from the dead, why didn't they tell us what they saw on the other side? At least they tell us that they saw something, even if they did not elaborate. preacher said, oh, God didn't let them tell us what they saw on the other side. Okay, I can do with that. Why in the fuck didn't they tell us that they saw something? And it was wonderful. Why didn't they tell us that? All we got is Paul's vague description of hearing voices that were not permissible to speak. Whoop the shit. Is that all there is, life after death? I do not believe these near-death experiences. These near-death experiences are working together to make me doubt whether Jesus is real. Because people have near-death experiences and they love Jesus. Yet the theology conflicts with others who have the same near-death experiences and love Jesus just as much as they do. One Lord, one faith, and one baptism. But I'm not seeing that. I'm seeing one Lord, one Jesus, but different faiths. One Jesus, but one person believes in the Jesus who became incarnated in alien worlds as an alien to save them from their sins and die for their sins. That goes against scripture. Jesus died more than once is blasphemy. That Howard Storm believes Jesus Christ died on other worlds for their sins. Not as a human being, but you say you got a world of fishmen living in another world. Howard Storm believes that Jesus became a fishman in their world and had to die for their sins. Christ, being raised again, dieth no more, the Bible says. For Christ died once, as it is appointed unto a man once to die, even so, Christ was offered once to bear the sins of many. Once. If there are alien worlds, why is not Jesus' death one time enough to save them too? Unless, of course, the devil's working overtime to deceive, and he's deceiving even Christians who are truly born again. But how can people like Howard Storm and these other believers truly love Jesus and yet believe a whack theology that's not quite on par with the theology of the ancient early church fathers? It is, but it isn't. Howard Storm does not believe in the God of wrath. Howard Storm does not believe God gets angry at sinners. So you know it's kind of whack. But yet, you read the theology of Howard Storm about getting saved, it lines in perfectly with the early church fathers. Here's why I'm terrified what happened when I'm dying. As I'm dying, my brain is dying. The wrong parts of my brain will stop dying first. Now I become someone that I am not. In my supposed near-death experience, when I'm supposedly coming out of my body, it's all in the brain. It's all in the head. All out-of-body experiences, meeting the light, it's all in the fucking head. Yes, I believe you can come out of the body, but it's all in the fucking head. Scientists say you only use 10% of your mind. They also say the mind is more vast than the entire universe. So, what's the big deal? If you are dying and suddenly you know everything that's true. What's the big fucking deal? The mind is more vast than the universe, so why in the fuck should the mind not know what we don't know? Duh. I'll be dying, and they'll think I'm dead if I'm coming out of my body. But you know, that one person, hey, like if you had TED trauma, you can forget or it can change your personality. What if I'm, while I'm dying, the parts of my brain die in such a way to cause me to become a different person, in the same way that as a person had suffered head trauma, he'd become a totally different person from the one he was before he had the head trauma. So, folks, I'm terrified of dying. I'm fucking terrified. Fuck that shit. I'm terrified because... I'm terrified of dying because is death the end? Until I see consciousness, my consciousness demonstrated why my body is rotting, I will not believe. I'm going to be like Thomas. Yes, I'm going to believe in Jesus. I'm going to hedge my bets. Do just enough to hedge my bets. But I'm not going to really seriously let it make me into a gung-ho, full throttle Christian until I get some of these fucking issues resolved. I'm a Christian. I believe in Jesus. But I'm going to hedge my bets. Just in case death is the end, I want to be a good-looking guy. I want to have my long forms. I want to enjoy this life, too. And get into heaven and be the lowest man on the totem pole, so poor in heaven that I don't even have, that to be homeless on the streets of gold. But I'll be there. At least I'll be there. So that's the way it goes. If I can get proof there's life after death, that would help me so much. If I can just know that there's life after death.